This vehicle represents freedom to me to get out and get around. I like being able to do everything myself. One of the biggest things after a stroke is you don't have the freedom. You rely on everybody to do everything for you.
About 800,000 people in the United States suffer a stroke each year, and it continues to be the leading cause of disability in adults in the United States. We're using virtual reality to facilitate the fastest, most efficient return to function for patients.
Recovery from a stroke is a very long process. Because the improvement is so slow, it's very challenging to keep them motivated and engaged.
We're trying to basically set up games that are appealing, compelling to the point that they'll play them on their own and that they're enjoying themselves to the point that they do it a lot. We feel like this is going to be a substantial improvement because it's going to be much more convenient and more cost-effective for patients to perform rehab in home as opposed to performing it in a clinic.
Having it inside your house is very good because you can do it any time during the day.
Which is flexible, and they're really on their own schedules, and they don't have to depend on their caregivers to drive them around.
When I first had the stroke, I couldn't imagine what I was going to do. It was absolutely, heart-wrenching. You feel like you're never going to be able to recover, but you can't give up. I'm still recovering, and hopefully I'll recover even better and better each day.